How is coronavirus detected? The rapid spread of the novel coronavirus, SARS coronavirus 2, poses a huge threat to global public health. In response to the sudden increase in demand for virus detection, companies and research institutes have developed many different virus detection methods and products. Of all these technologies, the colloidal gold-based immunochromatographic test is the fastest and least costly. These characteristics allow quick, large-scale screening tests for the novel coronavirus. This video shows how this method can detect the novel coronavirus. First, what is colloidal gold? Is it real gold? Colloidal gold is a sol, or colloidal suspension of nanoparticles of gold in a fluid, usually water. The colloidal suspension usually displays an intense red color when the nanoparticles are less than 100 nanometers in diameter. The color of the gold nanoparticles is used to detect the presence of the virus. So, colloidal gold contains real gold, but not in a form that can be used in trade. Colloidal gold is negatively charged and can easily conjugate or combine with antibody particles through static electricity. This is a colloidal gold-based immunochromatographic test strip. You can see a sample loading area, which allows samples from pharyngeal swabs, nasal swabs, and alveolar lavage fluids to be loaded on the strip. You can also see the testing area marked with the letters T and C. T stands for test, and C stands for control. Two red lines will be generated at the T and C areas of the result of a single test. A sample from an infected person will show two red lines. In contrast, a sample from an uninfected person will show only one red line in the control area, not in the test area. When a test strip is opened, you can see a sample pad, a conjugation pad, a test area, and an absorbent pad. The sample pad is where the test strip receives samples in the form of liquid drops. The absorbent pad generates a suction force, pulling the liquid from the sample pad toward the test area and the control area. A sample from an infected person will contain coronavirus antigens, which are the protein components of the coronavirus, such as spike proteins, envelope proteins, or other proteins. The sample liquid arrives first at the conjugation pad. This pad is covered with a large number of colloidal gold particles conjugated with antibody molecules. These antibody molecules recognize and bind to the coronavirus antigens. It is important to note that the colloidal gold particles must outnumber the coronavirus antigens so that there are always redundant colloidal gold particles not bound to the antigens. The bound and unbound colloidal gold particles are then pulled into the test area by the suction force generated by the absorbent pad. The testing area is coated with two types of antibody molecules. The T test area contains antibodies against the virus antigens. Here, the nanoparticles bound to antigens are captured and fixed in place. As the nanoparticles accumulate, a visible red color line appears. This indicates the presence of coronavirus antigens, and we call this a positive test. The unbound nanoparticles are not captured and continue to move to the next location, namely the control area. The control area is covered with antibodies against the antibodies binding to the gold nanoparticles. The gold nanoparticles are captured here to generate a second visible red line. The second red line is important for quality control. Its appearance means that the system is working properly. For example, suppose we have a negative result in the test area. Is this a true negative result or just something wrong with the test system? If we see the second red line, we know that this is a true test. Thanks for watching.